Ruffed grouse are the state bird. They need early successional habitat to thrive. If there weren't any humans in Pennsylvania, we probably wouldn't have a problem with early successional habitat naturally occurring. But since humans are in the picture, we actually have to manage the forest in order to keep those species all doing well. Here at DCNR, we use multiple methods of treating habitat for early successional species. Not only getting that early successional habitat from our timber sales, but also getting non-commercial, the areas where we don't harvest timber off of, making those areas better for early successional species like our state bird, the ruffed grouse.
Early successional species are generally the first to establish themselves quickly after some type of disturbance. We are essentially trying to replicate some of the events that are happening in nature. These might include a weather event, such as a tornado, or a wildfire, or an insect or pathogen outbreak. If left alone, early successional species tend to fade out of the forest composition. As the Bureau manages for timber species diversities, both early and late successional species are vitally important in the composition of the forest.
So the site here was strip mined about 25 years ago. So they use a large dozer with a ripper claw on the back of it, and they rip approximately lines every 8 feet, and so then it's cross-hatched. We would plant where the lines intersect. So this site was selected because it had been previously strip mined, reclaimed poorly, and then it was not growing well. As you can tell, it's coming back nicely. When we burn, it will top kill a lot of species, smaller shrub species like the scrub oak, and sets them back. And that's what we want to do, is set it back. So then immediately when the fire is over, it will start slowly to regenerate itself. And by the end of the summer, there should be shoots that are 5 or 6 inches out of that scrub oak. And the next year they'll be a couple feet tall. And so it's a very inexpensive effective way to set those plants back by top killing, kill everything above the ground and root system still intact. Fire is a much more economic way to treat areas than burning. You can treat a lot more acres a lot faster, a lot cheaper than you can by cutting. Whether you cut mechanically with a piece of equipment or whether you cut with chainsaws with people. Ecologically, it'll help remove the duff, which is like all the leaf material on the forest floor. Woodcock particularly like to have a clear forest floor right down to the soil so that they can probe with their bill into the forest soil. So it's very good for that. It kills ticks, that's great. And it preps the forest floor for things like acorns and other seed. What we're looking for is multiple stems per acre, many, many thousands of stems per acre. We want it to be a very difficult place to get through. That's what ruffed grouse really like. It's got to be very, very thick. Because aspen is a clone, and when it's cut, if you cut one, you might get back 100. So that it will root sprout from the roots, not just the stump. It actually sprouts from the roots as well. And we wanted to expand the clone from being 6 or 7 acres to maybe make it 7 or 8 acres. You can see the line between the aspen and the commercial species, the red oak, the white oak, the poplar, the cherry, the maple, et cetera. It's very distinctive, and that was part of the actual commercial timber sale that we sold to expand that clone.